Hello everyone, this is Nitpicky Nerd, and I just watched episode 4 of Star Trek Lower Decks, and I think it's a mixed bag. There are a few things which I really hated in this episode, but also a lot of things which I actually liked, and I think overall I liked more things than I disliked. So overall I did enjoy the episode, and there were a few laugh out loud moments. So there seems to be a pattern in the show, at least for me, that I only seem to enjoy the even number episodes and I don't enjoy the odd number episodes. And this kind of reminds me of the Star Trek movies, which also seem to have that kind of pattern, with the exception of Star Trek Nemesis, which I always hated, but for the most part the Star Trek movies seem to be the best in the even numbers, and the same kind of pattern is in this show for some reason, at least in my opinion. And I probably would have loved this episode if not for a few things which kind of annoyed me, so I'm going to analyze everything, I'm going to nitpick every little detail. So first of all, the opening I actually really loved because it finally seemed to be an actual science fiction idea. They showed some kind of ship, which they said is a generational ship, and its crew are in suspended animation, and the inside of it looked kind of like the Borg cube, how it looked like in Q-Who. Giant structures, and they had all kinds of containers which were dripping all kinds of strange goo, and that goo seemed to react with inorganic matter to create life, and all of that kind of reminds me of Prometheus with that black goo and all of that. So for the first time in a long time I actually found myself intrigued by a Star Trek episode which actually seemed to have some kind of science fiction idea, but then immediately they kind of put all of that in the background, and almost immediately Michael Tilly ruins everything. She starts yawning loudly and ruins everything, and the plot becomes all about her, and so I really hated that, and I thought I'm going to hate this episode because I want to see that story. I want to see the actual science fiction idea. That's why I used to love Star Trek. Of course, the characters and all the jokes and all that kind of stuff was always fun, but it wasn't the main reason I loved Star Trek. I loved Star Trek mostly because of the science fiction ideas in it. And that's what I want to see, and so they kind of teased me with it, and then they don't show anything about that, except the end maybe. That's why it redeemed itself a little bit, because they did do something with it later, but early on I really started hating this character even more, because she always makes everything about her, she doesn't care about, you know, the main reason that Starfleet exists, and so I really hated her in the beginning. And I get that this is supposed to be funny, but I just don't find it funny. I find it annoying. That's my biggest problem with the show so far. This character is making it almost unwatchable in some parts. And even the humor, they did do kind of parody of Star Trek TNG in a lot of places in this episode, but some of the time I felt like they're laughing at it and not with it, because they were kind of poking fun. Like, she comes in a staff meeting and she says, "Oh, what are you doing? Are you debating the Prime Directive here again?" And so those kinds of jokes, I find them extremely annoying, because you know what? I used to love all those scenes of them debating stuff like the Prime Directive. I used to love all that kind of questions in Star Trek. I find it intellectually interesting. And to hear a character kind of poking fun at that and saying all of that is stupid, I kind of find it insulting, because I never found it stupid. Maybe some people did. Maybe some people hated that part of Star Trek. And those people will find those jokes funny, because they'll say, "Oh, that was always boring, all that kind of stuff was boring, I just watched it for the space battles or whatever, I found all those staff meetings discussing all kinds of political topics boring," and so they would probably enjoy these kinds of jokes. I don't, because I find them insulting. And she even had a line at some place that she said, "I'm not laughing with you, I'm laughing at you." And that's exactly how a lot of parts in this episode felt like they're poking fun. They're kind of mocking all kinds of little things from TNG, even the poker games, you know, they often had those scenes of just the crew bonding and playing poker, and they seem to be poking fun at it here, saying it's boring, and I did find that a little bit funny, because you know what, real life poker games do tend to be mostly boring most of the time, because it's very rare that actually something really interesting happens, there's some kind of tension in which you don't know who will win, and so most of the time it is actually people just folding if you actually play the real poker game. And a few years ago I actually got into poker and I played a lot of poker, maybe because of TNG, because I wanted to experience the game that I always saw on TV and never played, and so a few years ago I actually got into poker, and most of the time it was kind of boring, and so that's why I do kind of find that joke a little bit funny, and those who play poker probably will also find it funny. So that's why I said this is a mixed bag. Some of the jokes did work in my opinion, but a few felt insulting and a few just weren't funny, to me at least. And there was one joke that I'm not sure if it was intended to be a joke or if it was just a coincidence, and that is the part in the beginning, after the opening credits, when we see all the executive producers and we see the name of Alex Kurtzman, but it appears under Michael Tilley just as she was talking about that Telluride guy and saying how boring he is, and she kind of pointed her hands down and it kind of seems to be pointed at the name of Alex Kurtzman, and she's saying that guy is so super boring and all of that. So I found that funny, but I'm not sure, maybe this was a coincidence and not deliberate, but I found it maybe the best unintentional comedy moment in the show. And maybe it was deliberate, maybe Mike McMahon secretly hates Alex Kurtzman and wanted to poke fun at him somehow, so he made it in such a way that he can claim plausible deniability, that he didn't know, that it was just a coincidence that the name Alex Kurtzman appeared when she was talking about someone super boring, and then the captain says he was boring for 15 years. So that little moment might be the best unintentional comedy or a secret joke that I've seen in the show. And speaking of that Telluride guy, I think there's a slight continuity mistake because Mariner was being rude in that staff meeting and he felt insulted. But I seem to remember that the Tellurites in Enterprise kind of enjoyed being rude toward each other, that they found it like flattery, and so shouldn't this guy like her because she's so rude to him? And so I found that kind of a little bit of a continuity mistake. And another small continuity mistake was in that whole subplot about Ascension. There was a guy on the ship who wants to ascend to become pure energy, and I think the show kind of confused the Ascension from Stargate SG-1 with the energy creatures we saw in Star Trek TNG. And they specifically named the Q and the Traveler as ascended beings, but to my knowledge the Traveler was never technically ascended. He was simply an alien with all kinds of magic powers, and the Q were said to always have existed, and so they did not actually evolve from biological corporeal beings who ascended. Instead, they always existed as those kinds of energy beings, according to some dialogue in Voyager. So I don't think those were good examples of ascended beings. Maybe they should have mentioned the Zalconians or the Organians, because they were organic beings, humanoids, who ascended into energy form, and so that would fit the dialogue much better. And I didn't find most of this subplot very interesting. I did love the ending when that guy kind of ascended but didn't want to and then started seeing crazy stuff. It was the kind of over-exaggerated and crazy stuff we often see in Rick and Morty, and I do like that show for that, and so I did enjoy that moment. And also the part in which the green Tilly accidentally ruined that guy's ascension in the beginning, and then she tries to fix it, and she goes to the replicator and asks for colored sand, and then a huge amount of sand drops on her hands. That moment was kind of funny to me, so there are a lot of moments which I did find very funny across this episode. That's why overall I did enjoy it. I also love that there was another bald guy in that room. I find it very funny how many bald guys there are on the ship. I guess it's a reference to Captain Picard and to the fact that in this future people don't care about losing their hair anymore. Maybe the producer, maybe Mike McMahon is bald. I didn't look it up, but it would be funny if he was. I also start to really love the character of Jack. He's the kind of Riker parody of the show. He's the first officer and he behaves like Riker in many ways. His body language, the way he always puts his leg on something, that is an obvious reference to Riker. But they also added his own mannerisms on top, meaning he is a muscular guy, he loves training, they mentioned that previously, and here we see that he accidentally notices his own muscles and starts to admire it, and so he kind of loves himself, he's in love with himself, kind of like, you know, Zeb Brenningon in Futurama. And so I think he's a funny character. I think he's been voiced by the guy who played the lead in Sliders, the old 90s TV show, which I actually was a fan of in the beginning. It was very good at first, then became total garbage, especially when that guy left, and so I forget his name, but I think he's voicing this guy Jack, and so he's actually a really funny side character. So we see him putting his leg on stuff all the time, so that's funny. Also visually, this show is paying very good attention to detail, like all the little stuff, the inside of the turbo shaft looks exactly like the one we saw in TNG one time. So they seem to be paying a lot of attention to the details, and also they finally do the holodeck joke that fans like me were always joking about. You know, what would most people use the holodeck for? We all know the answer, and so the way they did it here, at first I was annoyed that when she was cleaning the waste of the holodeck, it was some kind of green cloud, and I complained about this even when I just reviewed the first trailer for the show, and I said this joke would only be funny if it would be nastier, meaning we have to go into that, you know, not child-friendly territory to make it funny, otherwise it's not really funny. And the way they did it here was in a clever way in which they kind of said that, but without saying it, because they bleeped it out. So the guy, the Riker guy, told the captain what the holodeck is mostly being used for, but they bleeped out all the words, and so only the adults would get the joke and the kids wouldn't, and so this was a clever way to do that joke without doing it too nasty for the kids. And so overall I liked it. And then the Tellarite guy, who is the captain of the other Starfleet ship near them, decides that he wants to tow the alien ship faster. And so he gets closer to it with the tractor beam, and then it tears up parts of that ship, and then that alien Prometheus goo infects the ship. And by the way, speaking of the Tellarite guy, he actually looks like the Tellarite are supposed to look like, similar to the ones we saw in TOS and Enterprise, and not like the ones we saw in Star Trek Discovery, who were much taller, much bigger, with big tusks. And so the Tellarites here look like they're supposed to look like, much shorter than humans, with beards and without those giant tusks coming out of their face. And then the tractor beam accidentally beams some of that Prometheus goo onto the ship, and then the ship starts mutating, all kinds of biological stuff starts forming. And it kind of reminds me of that episode of TNG which was called Masks, in which the ship was transforming into all kinds of alien artifacts, but it wasn't done that well in that episode, meaning they never really showed the special effect. And here, because it's a cartoon, they can show a lot more stuff. And that's why I would like them to do actually science fiction ideas in the show, because as a cartoon, they actually have the ability to show a lot of crazy stuff much better than they ever could in the live action shows. And so that's the kind of stuff I would want to see in the show. The kind of crazy Rick and Morty bizarre science fiction stuff is the kind of stuff that in a cartoon form can be done very well. And that's why I did like that crazy ascension scene when he saw the giant koala outside the universe and all kinds of crazy stuff. It's really something that can only be done in a cartoon form, and that's the kind of stuff they should be doing more of. And I think I would have loved the show if not for Mariner being so annoying, and a lot of her jokes are not that funny, and that part of her being promoted to a senior officer and hating every moment of it, while Ensign Purple Hair is jealous of her because that's exactly everything he dreamed about. A lot of that just wasn't that funny. There were a few moments which were funny, for example when they keep showing that she now has her own giant room. And I guess she prefers to have bunkmates and all of that, but one of the moments shows that she's been called, I think, to the poker game, and then she kind of, I don't want to go, and then she kind of rolls off the bed and rolling on the floor towards the door. That moment, I did find it funny. And another small detail that annoyed me a little bit, they mentioned that the senior officers get better programs in their replicators, that they get to eat better food, because the lower decks guys don't get the same replicator menu, you can say, and I find that really strange. I mean, I guess technically maybe that would be a good way to get people motivated and want to be promoted, because, you know, they have no money in the 21st century, as Picard said, so why would anyone want to get promoted? But since you can offer them other incentives like bigger quarters, then that would explain why everybody works hard, because everybody wants to get promoted. And the room thing was mentioned in the episode Lower Decks in TNG, that they are actually roommates with each other. And that also makes sense, because this is a starship, they don't have infinite amount of empty space on the ship, so it would make sense that not everybody would get their own room, and that's why I was always fine with that. And yet here they mentioned that the food they eat is not as good as the one the senior officers get from the replicator, and the replicators themselves seem to be the same technology, but they simply don't get access to the best programs. And I find that a little bit annoying, because really, how cheap is Starfleet, or how nasty are they that they basically punish the Lower Decks guys by denying them access from certain foods in the replicator? And it also doesn't fit that famous speech by Picard that he said there are no material needs. Not just no money, so no more material needs, meaning anyone can get anything he wants, presumably out of the replicator. And so now we find out there is basically a form of credit system, or based on your rank, that you get access to better things. Again, some things that would make sense, for example, holodeck time. That's also something that was never really discussed in TNG, but presumably holodeck time is limited. You cannot go into the holodeck all day long, except if you're Barclay, I guess, then you can. But it never made sense, because I think they only had like maybe 5 or maybe 10 holodecks on the ship, but a crew of 1,000 people, and at any time they go into a holodeck it seems to be empty. But I guess they maybe reserve the time on the holodeck, and maybe senior officers get more time there, and that would make sense, because again, this would be a way to motivate people to work hard and to get promoted. And this is a resource that is actually limited on the ship. You cannot have infinite amounts of holodecks, but replicators, on the other hand, are in every single room. And so the only thing that is stopping the ensign from getting the food he wants is just some regulation. So that I find that little bit kind of annoying. I think holodeck time alone would be sufficient to motivate people. There's no need to punish the lower decks further by limiting the menu they would have on the replicator. And this also reminds me of something we saw in Star Trek Picard, when we saw those workers on Mars complaining about their replicators, saying the food tastes like crap. And I said in my review of that show that those kinds of things kind of ruin the optimistic vision of the future, that the future is going to be so bright and so good for everyone. And then we find out, oh no, that's only if you're the captain of a starship. So if you're lower decks, or if you're some worker, or if you're a civilian, apparently you're not going to get access to all those wonderful things, and you're going to have to do all the nasty menial jobs on the ship. So just like Mariner gets to clean the holodeck, basically, and that also doesn't fit what we heard in TNG when Riker said the ship cleans itself. And that seemed to indicate that no person has to do those dirty jobs anymore, and yet in this episode we see them do all kinds of stuff like that, and we also see Ensign Purple Hair cleaning the windows of the observation room, and that's also something we never saw before. I guess that was a clever way to just have him be there, but I would think things like that should be automatic on a starship, and we never saw anyone do that in the older Star Trek shows. But again, this is a comedy show, so I'm not really complaining about that. I'm just mentioning everything because you know my name, you know I'm nitpicking every little detail, but I didn't really have a problem with that. You know, we wouldn't get the holodeck joke if not for someone having to clean it. So I'm fine with that because I myself was making jokes like that in my TNG edits and my parodies, and so I cannot complain about jokes like that, which I myself used to do many times before. So I don't really have a problem with that, but the replicator program thing, that is annoying because it reminds me of Star Trek Picard, in which suddenly the replicators cannot produce food as tasty as real food, and suddenly the food from the replicator tastes like crap. This would mean that money should still exist because people will always want to get better food and better things, and if they now say that the replicators are just producing some cheap imitation which doesn't really taste that good, then this means that material needs do still exist. And so Picard was lying when he was making that speech, when he was telling that guy there is no more money, no more needs for possessions, basically because anyone can get anything. And yet apparently that's not the case, and so I don't like it when the new Star Trek shows kind of destroy all of that vision, and that's a complaint I have with all the recent Star Trek shows. It's a shame that this is the case in this show as well, which seems to be so similar to TNG in so many other things, and yet they sometimes do get a few details incorrectly. And so the part about Ascension, for example, that sounded a lot more like the Ascension we saw in Stargate SG-1 and not anything we saw in the Star Trek shows, except maybe the Zalconians, which was a species who had the biological ability to ascend, basically a mutation which allows them to ascend, and presumably that guy we saw in that episode, Transfigurations, he went on to teach others of his race, and maybe by the time of this show, maybe a lot more of them ascended, and so it would have been nice if they mentioned the Zalconians or the Organians from the original show. So I think those would have been better references instead of the Q and the Traveler, which were not technically ascended. So it's a mixed bag for me. Some of the jokes did work, but a lot of them didn't, and the humor is subjective, so maybe some people would love this, other people will hate this. For me, it's a mixed bag, so that's my opinion. Let me know what you think, and we can discuss it in the comment section below, and I will see you all next time. Bye-bye.